I'm Donald Osborne. I'm an historian, appraiser, consultant, and writer. And my special passion is for Italian cars, specifically coach-built Italian cars in the 1940s, 50s, 60s, and 70s. The 1955 Alfa 1900 CSS Buono Coupe. It's just one of the most exciting cars that I've ever come across. The design is so incredibly interesting. One of the main themes of the mid-century in car design, both in Italy and America, was the theme of the jet age. And in this car, you quite clearly see the whole fuselage aspect. It's like a jet plane for the road, that wonderful central spine that runs across the roof and down the split rear window. You see that in a lot of 1930s streamliners. And here, you also see there's no flat surfaces on this car at all, in plan or in section. It constantly curves. It's always moving from front to rear, from side to side, from top to bottom. It's absolutely extraordinary. And to me, that's the absolute quintessence of what this mid-century Italian style is all about. One of my absolute favorite cars in the collection that's being offered as well is the 1964 250 GT Berlinetta Lusso. I happen to think that it is one of the most beautiful road-going Ferraris ever designed. And the fact that it is very much a 250 GT, which is a legendary chassis, this great engine, this incredible chassis, married to this incredibly beautiful body. It's a car that, to me, looks right at every angle, in every light, in almost every color, and this color is absolutely stunning. This is absolutely one of the most beautiful examples I've ever seen. The interior with that wonderful central binnacle is just absolutely amazing. Sometimes there are cars that are great to drive, and sometimes there are cars that are great to look at. The 250 GT Berlinetta Lusso is both. This Alfa Romeo 60-2500 is a thrilling example of what everyone looks for in a pre-war Alfa Romeo. You want dashing looks, you want a great sound, you want great performance, it's really nimble, it's very usable, it's extremely attractive, so it's very welcome on the show field. So it's a car that's absolutely beautiful, that gets wonderful attention, and it's a car that's very useful. This particular car, it's not known what the original body of the car was, but the body it wears today, probably built by Carrozzeria Alfa, Alfa's own in-house body builders, for an earlier car, a 60-2300, which is a very, very popular, very successful car for Alfa Romeo before World War II. And the lines are absolutely gorgeous. And it's just an amazing car, great presence, a very exciting car to drive and to listen to. The Alfa G1 is the oldest known car bearing the Alfa Romeo badge after Niccolo Romeo took over the ALFA company. This particular model is set up as a racing car. However, the G1 was Alfa's first six-cylinder car built to be a luxury car to compete with Rolls-Royce. Most of the G1s were exported to Australia, and this particular example ended up, after being used in its original body form, as a work vehicle on a farm. And then in the late 40s, a fellow in Australia acquired the chassis, and knowing what it was, that this great purebred Alfa Romeo, he had constructed for it a sport touring body. What is more fun than driving a giant racing car around the street? And it's just an absolutely amazing thing, and just a window that we can look back into history and just see some of the earliest days of the Alfa Romeo company. It's quite thrilling.